you're in Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia, or New Zealand, whatever you have planned for in about 6 hours' time, just take a moment to look up. You'll be treated to the longest blood moon eclipse of this century. The total eclipse phase will last 1 hour and 43 minutes. The moon rising from the horizon tinged a deep, rusty red as it's totally eclipsed by the Earth. Unlike with a solar eclipse, no special equipment is needed. So fingers crossed, the weather's good. For more on this, I'm now joined by a space expert, Olivier Sangui. Olivier, thank you very much for being with us. Now, why don't we have a lunar eclipse every month?
Well, because the moon does not enter the shadow of Earth every month, because the moon is not on the same plane as the Earth and the Sun. So it's because of the celestial mechanic. But we do have a lunar eclipse roughly 2 times a year.
This one, though, I understand, is going to be particularly long, the longest of this century. Why is that?
Because the moon is going to go through the center of the Earth's shadow. But when we say longer, you know, it's going to be 103 minutes, and the maximum is, in fact, 107 minutes. So it's a record by 4 minutes or so. But, well, it's always fun to say, okay, it's the longest lunar eclipse of this century.
And why is it that we call this phenomenon a blood moon?
It's because we have the Earth's atmosphere. Luckily for us, we do have an atmosphere. So the atmosphere of the Earth refracts a portion of the sunlight, and it's the red part of this light that lights the moon. So the moon does have this copper or reddish, and in fact, it's impossible to say how is the exact color. We will see it tonight. It's impossible to say because it depends on the composition of the atmosphere. So what is that going to be the surprise?
And what would your tips be for stargazers? Is there a particular good place to watch it from, or a certain angle you should be watching it from?
Well, the important is to have a good horizon on the southeast, and then you will see the moon. It will be an easy target, and the moon will go out from the Earth's umbra around 9:13 universal time. And also, don't miss Mars. Just below the moon, you will see a red star. Of course, it is not a star. It's a planet. It's Mars.
I was going to ask you about that, because Mars, I understand, will also sparkle brighter than usual tonight.
Yes, it's going even to be the brightest star planet, of course. Tonight, it's because we are in opposition, meaning that you have the Sun, the Earth, and Mars. And Mars is very close from Earth right now. It is at 58 million kilometers, and it's a good opposition. 2 years ago, the opposition was at 76 million kilometers. That's why Mars is so bright tonight.